We need to open these small servos and attach a fourth wire to the pot inside here to give positive feedback to our circuit. The first thing you want to do is remove this label and all the sticky stuff. That label tends to overlap the bottom part of this case and will make it difficult to open. When you remove the bottom cover, you very gently push these wires to one side and you will see three solder connections sticking up through the board. As it turns out, the center pin is the connection to the wiper on the pot. That little square opening is there to allow this wire to pass. We're going to take a grinder and grind a little bit of that away. Make that a bit wider so that it will clear four wires instead of three. It's not a bad idea to put a little bit of tape on both sides of this just to keep this from accidentally coming apart and dumping all these gears out on the bench. We have no reason to open this up any further. My helping hand will be this quick clamp, and I need to come in here with the soldering iron and be very careful not to touch anything except this one pin. My wire has already been tinned on the end with just a slight amount of solder on the soldering iron. I want to come in and touch that, get on and get off of that. Very gently put those wires back. And we take the case with the modified slot, put it on top of there, and we have all four wires coming out. Put the screws back in there. Time the threads. And we're done. We can see our center tap wire through the clear case. I now have four servos with a feedback wire, one brown, one pink, white, and one orange or coral. I'm not really sure what color that is. But anyway, it's easy to differentiate from one servo to another. And I only need three of these for what we're doing right now. In radio control applications, when we move a joystick or a switch on the transmitter, a signal is sent to the receiver, which in turn sends a signal through this wire to the servo to tell it to change position. There is no feedback. The feedback that we get is visual, and we can visually verify if the plane is doing what we want it to. In this application, once the servo is powered up, it will send a feedback signal through this wire to the Nano telling it what position the servo is currently in. And then the Nano can send the signal to the servo how much it wants it to change that position and at what rate of travel. So our programming for this movement should be much smoother. In this maze of wires, I have a 5.5 volt battery pack with positive connected to the red wire for the servo, negative connected to the brown wire. The signal wire is not being used. The white feedback wire is connected to the red lead from the multimeter. The black lead is connected back here to ground. When I turn this on, when I turn the servo all the way to one deflection, I have 2.463, and I turn it all the way the other way, I have 0.568. And it's the difference in those two that I'm interested in, which is about 1.9. Haven't watched one of these before? Please check it out. No law against watching a video more than once, and it will help support this channel. Thank you for watching. I appreciate it.